So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and above. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions, or if you can ask any doubts. And we have launched our RBI Grade B Crash Course, and you can avail a discount of 40% by using the coupon code of CRASH40. So just go to www.anujindal.in. You can have it here on the website, right? So let's begin with the very first question. What is the target for ground level credit for the financial year 2022? Now, what is this ground level credit? We will discuss about this later. So, there is a target for this financial year, that is the financial year 2022. For the ground level credit, you have to tell about that target. Okay. So, let's discuss about this first. So, guys, the Union Finance Minister, who is of course Nirmala Sitharaman, has announced that there is a target of 16.5 lakh crore. Alright. 16.50 lakh crores. I think I forgot to mention this here. 16.50 lakh crore ka target hai, wo set kiya gaya hai for the ground level credit for the financial year 2022. And this ground level credit policy, guys, was announced by the Union Government in the financial year 2003-04 mein isko announce kiya gaya tha. Ye hota kya hai? Basically, under this policy, Government of India announces GLC targets, ground level credit targets for the agriculture and allied sector in the Union budget every year, which every bank has to complete. हर बैंक को उतना क्रेडिट जो है वो एग्रीकल्चर और अलाइड एक्टिविटीज को देना ही पड़ेगा. ओके, सो दिस इज द ग्राउंड लेवल क्रेडिट इन द फील्ड ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर. सो आई होप द मीनिंग ऑफ ग्राउंड लेवल क्रेडिट इज क्लियर. बेसिकली ग्राउंड लेवल क्रेडिट इज द टारगेट विच इज सेट एवरी ईयर इन द यूनियन बजट बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, और जिस टारगेट को हर बैंक को पूरा करना होता है उतना क्रेडिट इन द फील्ड ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड अलाइड सेक्टर उन बैंक्स को देना ही पड़ेगा. ओके, so I hope this news is clear, and the correct answer therefore to this question, guys, is option B, 16.50 lakh crore, 16.50 lakh crore ka target hai for the ground level credit in agriculture for the financial year 2022. Okay, now let's move on to next question, which is a very important question, and it is from the social issues. Isme se direct aapka question aa sakta hai in the descriptive part. Consider the following statements regarding the committee formed by the government of India for sub-categorization of OBCs, and you have to identify the correct statement. So for sub-categorization of OBC, a committee was formed by the Government of India. You have to identify the correct statements regarding that committee. Alright. And the name of the committee, guys, is named after Justice Rohini. So the name of the commission is what? Rohini Commission. And this is in news because the center has extended the tenure of this commission until 31st July 2021. 31 जुलाई 2021 तक इसका जो टेन्योर था रिपोर्ट सबमिट करने का उसको एक्सटेंड कर दिया गया है, इसको बढ़ा दिया गया है बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस कमीशन, गाइस, सो इट वाज फॉर्म इन द ईयर 2017 में इसको एस्टैब्लिश किया गया था फॉर द विद एन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ सब कैटेगराइजेशन ऑफ ओबीसी. जो ओबीसी है उसको सब कैटेगराइज करने के लिए दिस कमिटी वॉज फॉर्म इन द ईयर 2017 under article 340 of the constitution of India. Now what is this article 340 says? So article 340, guys, mandates the appointment of a commission to investigate the matter related to OBCs. OBC se related, OBC ke jo bhi halaat hain unke matter se related jo bhi cheeze hain usko investigate karne ke liye commission banaya jayega under article 340, and therefore under article 340 this commission was formed by the government of India in the year 2017. All right, and what was the need for sub categorization, guys? What was the need? So this need arises out of the perception in that only a few affluent community among the over 2600 included in the central list of OBCs have secured a major part of this 27% reservation. Basically, ये माना जाता है कि जो 27% reservation कोटा है उसमें केवल कुछ communities हैं OBC के अंदर वही benefit ले पा रही हैं, बाकी जो और भी सारी ऐसी communities हैं जिनको benefit properly नहीं मिल पा रहा है. And that is why there is a need of sub-categorization of OBCs, right? Now, this commission ki kuch findings bhi hai, there are some findings of the commission. So till now, the commission has found that 97% of all jobs and educational seats in the central higher education, yahan pe hum baat kar rahe hain kiski, central higher education institutions ki baat kar rahe hain. 97% of all jobs in educational seats have gone to just 25% of all the subcastes which are classified as OBCs. 24.95% of these jobs and seats have gone to just 10 OBC communities. केवल 10 OBC communities ऐसी हैं जिनको इसका 24.95% जॉब दिया गया है. 983 OBC communities are there, which is 37% of the total, have zero representation in jobs. कोई representation नहीं है उनका. So this is a very alarming news for the OBC section and of course for all of us, because अगर सोसाइटी का एक पार्ट अफेक्टेड होगा देन ऑल ऑफ अस विल बी अफेक्टेड. ऑलराइट. एंड 994 ओबीसी सबकास्ट हैव अ टोटल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ जस्ट 2.68% इन रिक्रूटमेंट एंड एडमिशंस इन द हायर एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन. सो गाइस, दिस इज अ वेरी अलार्मिंग न्यूज फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द डेटा फ्रॉम वेरियस सर्विसेज, सो दिस कमीशन हैज फाउंड दैट ओनली 16.51% ओबीसीज आर देयर इन द ग्रुप ए सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट सर्विसेज, 13.38% in Group B Central Government Services, 21.25% in Group C, excluding the Safai Karamchari, while 17.72% in Group C, including Safai Karamchari. So this is the data from the various surveys, and iski committee ki bahut sari findings hai, which are not important for the exam. These two things are very important, just remember these, alright. And of course, the name of the commission is what? Rohini Commission. Now, let's move on to the question. So you have to identify the correct statement regarding this commission. So the committee is named as Rohini Commission. Yes, this is absolutely correct. It is named after Justice Rohini, who is the chairperson of this commission. The committee found that 16.51% in Group A services are OBC. Yes, this is also absolutely correct. And the tenure of committee has been extended till 31st July 2021. That is why it was in news. So this statement is also correct. So which means all are correct. Option E. All our correct should be the correct answer, alright? And now let's move into question number 3, which can be asked guys in your one marker, and this is a very important question. Which state has become the first state in India to implement e-cabinet? Matlab ki jo cabinet ki jitni bhi proceedings hongi, that will be paperless. All the proceedings, all the meetings of the cabinets will be paperless from now onwards in this state, jiske baare mein ye question bol raha hai. And this state guys is Himachal Pradesh. Alright, this state is what? Himachal Pradesh. So Himachal Pradesh has become the first state in India to have cabinet as the paperless, to have the paperless cabinet. Basically, उन्होंने implement कर दिया है किसको? E-cabinet को. And for this purpose, an e-cabinet app has been developed by the IT department of Himachal Pradesh. जो information technology department है Himachal Pradesh का, उसने इसके लिए एक app भी बनाई है जिसका नाम e-cabinet app रखा हुआ है अभी, और आगे कुछ और होगा तो they will tell. And similarly, on the same lines, Government of India also has an ambitious project of making all the parliamentary proceedings paperless under the National E-Vidhan project. If you remember, the National E-Vidhan project, under which government intends to make all the parliamentary proceedings paperless. Okay. So therefore, guys, the correct answer to this question should be what? Option B, Himachal Pradesh. And remember, this is a very important question. This can be asked with your one marker in ESI. Right. And now let's move ahead to question number 4. India's first. This is also important because this question talks about something which is India's first. Thunderstorm test bed. Now, what is this thunderstorm test bed? So basically, is test bed se hum ye andaaza laga payenge ki thunderstorm aane wala hai aur lightning ki jo strike hai wo hone wali hai, right? So India's first thunderstorm test bed will be established in Balasore, which is of course in Odisha. This test bed will be established in collaboration between various organizations and ministries. So the question is, which of the following is not one of these organizations or ministries? इनमें से कौन सा वो organization और ministry नहीं है जिनके collaboration से ये India का पहला thunderstorm testbed बनाया जाएगा, alright? So the news is that the India's first thunderstorm testbed will be established in Balasore, which is in Odisha, as announced by IMD, India Meteorological Department, which is headquartered in New Delhi, and Dr. Mrityunjay Mohapatra is the chairperson of IMD. Okay. And why? So it is very clear, the name suggests it is India's first thunderstorm research testbed. So it will keep a check on lightning strikes in Odisha and also in the eastern parts of our country. And this will be established in collaboration between the Ministry of Earth Sciences, IMD, DRDO, and ISRO. चार ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस एंड मिनिस्ट्रीज का ये बेसिकली ये कोलैबोरेशन होगा. मिनिस्ट्री एक है मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्थ साइंसेज, IMD, DRDO and ISRO. And remember, don't confuse between Ministry of Earth Sciences and the Ministry of Science and Technology. Ministry of Science and Technology is not one of the collaborating partner here. Okay. And it was also announced to establish the monsoon test bed near Bhopal very soon. Dr. Mrityunjay Mohapatra ne announced kiya ki Bhopal mein we will be establishing a monsoon test bed also in near future. Okay. So I hope you can easily answer this question now. You have to tell which of the following is not one of these organizations of or ministries. Option C. Ministry of Science and Technology is not one of them. And Ministry of Science and Technology and Ministry of Earth Sciences both are headed by Dr. Harshvardhan, and he is also the Minister of Health and Family Welfare. His Lok Sabha constituency is Chandni Chowk, which is of course in New Delhi. Alright. So guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.